Now see question number 2. From the top of a temple 80 meters high. So we are denoting a temple 80 meters high. So this is the temple. This is the tip of the temple. This is the top part, foot of the temple and top part of the temple. That is 80 meters high. The angles of depression of two scooters at the same level and same side of it. So temple is standing on the ground. And on the same side of the temple and at the same level, there are two scooters. We have two scooters. Now these two scooters, they are making the angles of depression from the top of the temple, the angles of depression to these two scooters. Top of the temple, the angles of depression of two scooters. Now let us mark the temple as AB. And the position of two scooters as C and D. So observation is made from level A, top of the temple, and two angles of depression are formed with two objects at a lower level compared to position A. So those two levels of position for scooters are C and D, and the angles of depression are alpha and beta. We don't know which angle is alpha and beta, but we have to find out. Where tan alpha is given as 4 by 5 and tan beta is 1 by 4. You have to make use of these two ratios to find the distance between the two scooters. So, we should know how to draw the angles of depression and how to know which angle will be marked alpha, which will be marked beta. Now, here you see, when you want to draw angles of depression or elevation, you have to draw the line at which the observation is made. Observation is made at A. So you draw a line passing through point A and parallel to the ground. This is the level at which the observation is made from top of the temple. Now angles of depression, as we have seen earlier, it should be down. The angles are subtended by objects set down to this line of observation. So we will have one line drawn from A to C, another line drawn from A to D. So two angles of depressions are formed. How? The first angle of depression, this should be a little more straight. Two angles of depression, how? It makes with the observation, line of observation. First there's a smaller angle of depression and there's a larger angle of depression. So we should know which is the smaller angle, which is the larger angle. Now see here, we have been given tan alpha is equal to 4 by 5, which is 0.8. And tan beta, we have been given as 1 by 4, which is equal to 0.25. Now if you compare 0.8 with 0.25, 0.80 two places of 10. So when you see that tan alpha is more, the greater the value of tan of an angle, the greater is the angle. If you remember your standard angles table, sine of an angle and tan of an angle increases with the increase in angle. Cos value decreases. So tan alpha has a larger value, tan beta has a smaller value. So between these two angles, alpha will be a larger angle and beta will be a smaller angle. Why? Because the value of tan alpha is more than tan beta. So first you have to know which angle is more and which angle is less. Now angle alpha is a larger angle, beta is a smaller angle, we concluded by seeing the value of the tan. So the smaller angle will be beta and the larger angle is alpha. This we came to know from here. So now if we want to calculate or make use, you will see that this angle is interior alternate to this. So this angle is beta and this angle is alpha. We have come to know that alpha is a larger angle. So this full larger angle is interior alternate with angle ACD. So from these two angles of depression, we are marking the two angles at the base. Now we will use these values to calculate the distance between the two scooters. So all of you just see now, in triangle ABC, we have tan alpha is equal to the opposite side AB by BC. AB by BC. So we know tan alpha is given as 4 by 5. So 4 by 5 is equal to 80 meters. AB is 80. BC is unknown to us. So BC we have to calculate by using this relation or equation. So if I bring BC, so 4BC is equal to 80 meters into 5, and only BC will be equal to 80 meters into 5 by 4, which means directly you would have taken the fraction 4 by 5 as 5 by 4. That also is correct. Now we have 420, so BC 20 into 5, we got the length of BC as 100 meters. By using tan alpha and this length of temple or AB, we got the length of BC as 100 meters. Now let us concentrate on the other triangle, ADB. ADB. So ADB, in triangle ADB, in triangle ADB, we have tan beta. Again, opposite side is same AB, but now the adjacent side is full BD, by BD. So tan beta was 1 by 4 is equal to AB 80 meter. BD is how much? BD is unknown, we have to find. So if you cross multiply, you will get BD as 80 meters into 4. That is BD is equal to 320 meters. So BD's length we got as 320 meters. This is the length of BD. So this full length BD is 320 and only BC is 100. So the distance between the two scooters is CD. So we can now write CD is equal to BD minus BC. So BD was 320 meters we have got from here, minus BC was 100 meters. So finally your length is 220 meters. The distance between the two scooters, you have to write in a statement, distance between the two scooters is 220 meters. CD denotes the length of the distance between two scooters. Now what was important in this sum is that before you draw the angles of depression, you should draw the line of observation. Then you know that the scooters are at a lower level, so you will get angle of depression. So from the two objects, you have to draw lines to subtend angles with the observer where the observation is made. So we get a smaller angle, we get a larger angle from this line. So this line is very important, that has to be drawn first. After you get, then you know which angle is alpha beta from your values. Then you take the help of trigonometrical ratio tan and get the result and solve this.